One of Mike's favourite cars.
When VW launched the Carrano back in 1988, it almost transformed their company's reputation overnight. You see, up until then, they had a slightly dour image. And then they released the Carrano. And in VR6 form, this car is a super coupe with 190 brake horsepower that propel you from 0 to 60 in under 7 seconds. And believe you me, that's pretty quick. Despite impressive sales and high critical acclaim, the car only remained in production for 6 years. VW needed to cut costs, so they cut one of the most impressive creations yet. Gareth has got one of the most desirable Carranos, a VR6. He reckons it won't take him long to shift it. Let's see what happens.
Hi, my name's Gareth Darby. This is my Carrano VR6, which I love and adore. But unfortunately, as I've just become a father, we need a more practical car, so I'm going to have to sell it.
I love the Carrano. It really is a very nice car. It's a driver's car. Everything's set up, you know, I mean, it's comfortable to sit in. It goes around the corner as well. A very fast car.
This is my girlfriend, Tanya. And this is my little boy, Reese, who's 10 days old today. He's the part of the reason we're selling the Carrano, and I hope he appreciates the sacrifice we're making.
We've gone down to the shop where we were going to get the pram from, just to see how it was going to fit into the boot. And there was no way it was going to go in there. We had the parcel shelf out and we had the rear seats down. And, you know, just it wasn't going to happen. So I was sad to see it go, but I've got a baby boy instead now, so.
I've got a routine that I do every Sunday or, you know, at least once a week. I like to clean the car, chamois it, wax it, polish all the windows, dress all the tyres, and I clean under the engine. If you're going to have a car, you might as well look after it, so it's what I enjoy doing. So I'm looking for $8,995 for the Carrano, which I think is a fair price, considering it's in good condition and it's been well looked after. My insurance is coming to an end soon, and I've got to pay off the loan on the new car. So hopefully I won't have to go down too much, but, you know, if push comes to shove, I'd take $8,500 for it. But let's hope we don't have to go that low.
The VW Carrano comes in a variety of different flavours. You get a 1.8, a 2-litre 16 valve, the supercharged G60, and the silky smooth 2.9 VR6. They're incredibly reliable, but the VW Carrano was the first Volkswagen to smash the 150-mile-an-hour barrier, which means they may have been fresh. So when you're buying one, choose very carefully. A rule of thumb is to go through the service history with a fine-tooth comb and make sure every stamp is present. If it's from a Volkswagen dealer, it makes the car a lot more valuable and also more desirable.
With so many official VW agencies around, parts and servicing are not a problem on Carranas. But these parts are quite expensive because they are high-performance cars. A catalytic converter, for example, will cost £470 to replace, and a full exhaust system will cost a staggering £1,200 to replace. Now, the only gimmick on a Carrano is this rear spoiler that lifts automatically at 40 miles an hour and also can be raised manually. Now, make sure it does work, because if it doesn't, that's going to cost another £300 to sort out. Gareth has really looked after his car. It's in lovely condition. He's got a top specification interior. It's a future classic in the making. It's worth £8,350.
Listen, they're fun, they're incredibly popular, and I'd expect him to get every penny of £8,500 for it. Let's find out.
Right, a chap's just phoned. He wants to come and look at the Carrano. Sounds pretty genuine, and I've dug up all my receipts, so we'll see how it goes.
Hi, I'm Andy. I've come to look at Gareth's Carrano. I've been looking for a Carrano for a little while now, and this has been the fourth one I've looked at, so hopefully it might be the one for me.
What I'm thinking of doing, I might have to get an RAC check done on it.
Yeah, for free, yeah.
And any offer I'd make, that'd be subject to them.
They said that it was in good condition and nothing needed doing.
Yeah, if they came up with something major, yeah, I wouldn't want that.
Yeah,
I'd like that.
So you don't know of anything that's not working on it or anything like that?
No. I mean, I'm not selling it because, you know, I'm fed up with it or because anything's majorly wrong with it. I'm selling it, but, you know, because I've got to.
I'd consider offering 8.85 for it.
Yeah.
I don't know how you'd consider that.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, you want to have your RAC check.
But that, I'd offer 8.5, and if an RAC check brought anything out that was wrong on it, then, you know, we'd renegotiate just on the price, but I don't know how that sounds to you.
Yeah, I mean, that's basically what I'm looking for.
It looks like we could have a deal then.
All right. Pleasure.
So, as agreed, the following week, the RAC come round to give the car a once-over.
I've got no reason to be worried, because they shouldn't find anything. I mean, there's nothing to find, but I don't know, it's the moment of truth now.
The check reveals that as well as a host of minor problems, the car needs a new head gasket and is leaking oil. The tracking is out, it's done 15,000 more miles than the clock is showing, and it's a year older than Gareth thought. In a bid to keep the sale on track, Gareth suggests that they take the car to his local garage to get a quote for the necessary repairs.
What I want to do, really, because of the extra, it's a bit older and the extra mileage that we've located on the car, I want to think about it over the weekend. I'm still very interested, but I'm going to take some advice from the VW place where I go and get back to you on a possible offer.
Sure.
1 week and 700 quid of Gareth's money later, Andy comes back to retest drive the Corrado. But he thinks the tracking is still out, and after his homemade paper oil leak test, he's worried that the engine may still be leaking oil. He decides he's just not happy with the repairs and backs out of the deal.
I'm looking ahead at few potential problems. I look at worst case scenarios.
Yeah.
To me, that could be a simple problem as a tracking, or worst case, it could be a steering rack.
Yeah.
And if you're talking a steering rack,
you're talking a lot of money.
You're talking a lot more money, and having that is where I play safe, and I won't buy it unless it's either sorted, or I take off the maximum risk. That's the way I play the game.
To be perfectly honest, I do think he was being very picky. He didn't force me to spend all the money out getting the bits done, and he hasn't forced me to go out for test drives or anything. You know, I have offered because, you know, being the vendor, you want to do your bit, but you know, I'm pretty fed up now that, you know, he didn't buy the car.
Gareth learnt a costly lesson there. You can never spend too much time looking over a car before you buy it.